So as we mentioned, these things get used a lot in these power electronic modules, right? Converting DC to AC or vice versa, depending how it's configured. And, you know, some interesting things happen. If you look at something like this, Charles, what kind of spectral content do you expect in a signal like that?
I expect a square wave, a single frequency that I would be turning this on and off at, maybe.
Yeah, so we have like the carrier frequency, like in that case, it was 2000 hertz. And then with a square, you know, you're going to have harmonics of that, right?
Yeah,
sometimes these things show up in our noise and vibration data. In fact, that PWM signal from the power electronics can often have like the highest noise or vibration level. So here I got some data. Where is the PWM signal showing up? This is what kind of data here? It's a vibration. So what's
looks
your
like I guess the carrier frequency of 5000, and then like you said, those harmonics as well.
Yeah, we got a 5000 hertz carrier frequency, and then we got these so-called switching frequencies that are harmonics. And the motor, it's actually increasing in speed. So if we were to look at some of the basic orders of the motor, like an electric motor, we got the imbalance of the shaft, and then we have like the stators and all this kind of stuff. So in this case, the motor is doing what? If the frequency is increasing, the motor must be
speeding up.
Speeding up, yeah. And actually, you can tell it's speeding up. In the PWM, you'll actually see that the harmonics are getting farther apart. Do you see that here, Charles?
Yeah, I can see that. Definitely.
Yeah, so the fact that the switching frequencies get farther apart means we're telling some motor somewhere to increase in speed, and that actually shows up in the noise and vibration spectrum. If you've been looking at some color maps and you're like, well, I understand these orders, you know, they're very traditional, but I see some orders that look like chicken feet. Or I don't know how you would describe that.
That sounds good. You must be hungry.
Yeah, and they're not going through zero hertz. They're at this, you know, the carrier frequency. That is power electronics or an inverter that's showing up. And it could be electrical noise, but it could actually be noise or vibration that's induced by the power electronics that's driving that. Some data with these power electronics, and it's in an active picture. So nice feature of Test Lab, of course, is I can interact with my data within PowerPoint. I got a nice order cursor here, and you know, these are the orders from that motor, right?
Yeah, typical.
And so far, well, if I can make the line, I'll just make it a little bit wider or something. Okay, now my power electronics are around 5000 hertz, and they seem to have an order. Yeah. I'm kind of mystified, Charles. If I want to analyze that, I did put on the numbers there. If I want to analyze this 5000 hertz PWM signal, what? My order cursor doesn't quite line up. It goes through zero here always.
Exactly.
What do I do, man?
It'd be nice to have a feature to kind of maybe offset that.
Offset it? What do you mean by offset?
So that it's centered through that carrier frequency, 5000 hertz would be good.
Oh, like it'd be nice if I could just double click on this. Oh, look at that. You can. And so, yeah, if I type in 5000 hertz, well, look at that, Charles. I can actually now line up on that PWM frequency and find out what the main harmonics are, et cetera. You know, to analyze the PWM frequency. That kind of makes sense to you, Charles?
Yeah.
Wait, did you know you could do that?
I have tried that before. Very useful.
Now that we're experts on this, I'm going to present some different PWM color maps. And we'll see if we can interpret what's going on there. So it's kind of like a quiz, Charles. So what do we have going on here?
I definitely see a carrier frequency. And
yeah,
some,
where? What's the carrier?
Looks. I don't know. Is that maybe 10,000?
Yeah, and usually, you know, a lot of PWMs, 2,500, 5,000, 10,000. So yeah, halfway between 8,000 and 12,000 is 10,000 hertz.
Yep.
So this color map was a little different than the other ones. We flipped the frequency axis and the RPM or time axis, right? That's a feature in Test Lab to swap those around. So, okay, so we got a 10,000 hertz carrier. And then what else is happening here?
I see, I guess what we're referring to them as switching frequencies, getting wider initially over the first, maybe half the time there, first eight seconds or so or something.
Yeah.
And so they're diverging initially. So I guess it was speeding up. And
yeah.
Then it started to slow down, it looks like, because they're converging.
Yeah, so the electric motor orders, you know, you'd expect to see them coming down in frequency. When these are converging together, when they're diverging, we're increasing in speed. Yeah, so that's one art piece in the gallery of PWM that we have here. Shall we look at another one?
Sure.
That one sold at auction for, you know, we had a non-fungible token with it. No. All right, let's look at this. I could see some PWM in here. So what's going on?
Well, number one, it looks like the loudest, I guess, yeah, we're looking at pressure. The loudest sound pressure is happening related to something with our power electronics there. I don't know, let me see what frequency. Is that 5,000 P? That carrier frequency is,
yeah,
that?
Roughly 5,000. Although I think this is kind of a special carrier frequency, so to speak, in that the it doesn't stay right at 5,000, right? It kind of meanders a little.
Exactly.
That's kind of interesting. And yeah, it gets loud. And then what happens?
Oh, it changes. Looks like it jumps up.
Yeah. So down here are the electric motor orders, right? They didn't jump or anything because the motor is still increasing in speed, but our PWM did change, and that's not too uncommon. You can, you know, as you're running these power electronics, you can change the carrier frequency when you want. And the reason they do this, you can, I think of it as kind of a, like a gear shift. You know how, like, when you're initially taking off at low speeds, you're in a low gear. Right.
Definitely.
And then as you get up to higher speeds, you get into a higher gear. Same thing with power electronics. Typically, I believe they deliver more power and maybe are a little less efficient when the carrier frequency is low. And then as you get up in speed, you don't need quite as much power. You want to run a little more efficiency as you start switching at a higher rate, carrier frequency wise. So what we're seeing here with these two different chicken feet, I kind of think of as like it's the shifting gear in on an electric motor sense. And why would we want to like increase the carrier other than efficiency and power delivery?
I guess maybe it goes back acoustics from an aviation standpoint. It would be less annoying for us or harder for us to hear it at the higher frequency.
Yeah, as acoustics guys, we'd like to see this stuff all be pretty high up where people can't hear as well, switching frequencies.